Hey, grade six, it's Mr. Stone here. Today's video is about blank verse with iambic pentameter. I love Shakespearean writing, and blank verse is something that he regularly used throughout his plays, and he used iambic pentameter. That may sound a little bit scary, but it is quite easy to write. You'll find that you naturally speak like that anyway when you're talking about specific things. It is all about stress. And you know how much us teachers love stress. We love making you stressed with all the work that we give you. So I'm going to start this video by clicking into another video, a video within a video about stress. One of my favorite TV shows, The IT Crowd.
Quite suitable for you guys. Your last chance. If the needle goes beyond here, you will be fired. Does that make you feel stressed? Jen, does it? No? Are you sure? Are you sure? Are you sure? See this balloon, Jen? I gotta burst it. But I'm not gonna tell you when. Do you feel stressed, Jen? Jen, look at that. That's your peace of mind. It's gonna go bang. Do you feel stressed now, Jen?
So it's not that kind of stress, it's the stress on syllables. So we're going to watch another video here. I've cut the first minute and 53 out. I will comment, I will put all of the videos I'm using in the details below because it's not my work. So I'll click into here.
Trochee, a stressed syllable followed by an unstressed one.
This is trochee.
The trochees in these lines from Shakespeare's Macbeth lend an ominous and spooky tone to the witch's chant. Double, double, toil and trouble, fire, burn and cauldron, bubble. But with Shakespeare, it's all about the iamb. This two-syllable foot is like a reverse trochee, so the first syllable is unstressed and the second is stressed. As in, to be or not to be.
That is the question.
Shakespeare's favourite metre in particular was iambic pentameter, where each line of verse is made up of five two-syllable iambs for a total of 10 syllables. And it's used for many of Shakespeare's most famous lines. Shall I compare thee to a summer's day? Arise, fair sun, and kill the envious moon. Notice how the iambs cut across both punctuation and word separation. Meter is all about sound, not spelling. Iambic pentameter may sound technical, but there's an easy way to remember what it means. The word iamb is pronounced just like the phrase I am. Now let's expand that to a sentence that just happens to be in iambic pentameter. I am a pirate with a wooden leg. The pirate can only walk in iambs, a living reminder of Shakespeare's favourite metre. Iambic pentameter is when he takes 10 steps. Our pirate friend can even help us remember how to properly mark it if we imagine the footprints he leaves walking along a deserted island beach. A curve for unstressed syllables, and a short line for stressed ones. If music be the food of love, play on. Of course, most lines of Shakespeare's plays are written in regular prose. But if you read carefully, you'll notice that Shakespeare's characters turn to poetry, and iambic pentameter in particular, for many of the same reasons that we look to poetry in our own lives. Feeling passionate, introspective, or momentous. Whether it's Hamlet pondering his existence, or Romeo professing his love, the characters switch to iambic pentameter when speaking about their emotions and their place in the world. Which leaves just one last question. Why did Shakespeare choose iambic pentameter for these moments rather than, say, trochaic hexameter or dactylic tetrameter? It's been said that iambic pentameter was easy for his actors to memorize and for the audience to understand, because it's naturally suited to the English language. But there might be another reason. The next time you're in a heightened emotional situation like the ones that make Shakespeare's characters burst into verse, put your hand over the left side of your chest. What do you feel? That's your heart beating in iambs.
Da-dum, 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 da-dum.
Shakespeare's most poetic lines don't just talk about matters of the heart, they follow its rhythm.
I do feel guilty putting videos in there into my videos, but that's just so good. So that heartbeat, da-dum, 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 is what we're trying to write with our poem this week, okay, our blank verse. Your blank verse can be written about anything you want to. There's no rhyming rules with it. It shouldn't rhyme. Just 10 syllables per line in 5 feet. So each feet with the stress being on the second syllable. You'll find that most sentences that you write follow that pattern anyway. If somehow you find that the emphasis is on the first syllable, just try and add a word in before it, and then it will get into that pattern for you. Now, I am and penta are from the Greek language. I've pulled them up here. Okay, iamb is a metrical foot used in various types of poetry. And it is the two, and penta meaning five. Okay, so the iambic pentameter coming from those Greek words. And so I thought, putting two Greek words together, thinking about the English language, how it comes from Greek, it comes from Arabic, it comes from Latin, then I might write my poem on weird English words. So I was looking at ideas from this Creative Writing Now webpage, and I was looking at rain and snow, which is sort of typical for this weekend. Something that's beautiful, a house where you're born, smells. I was thinking about getting spices out of the cupboard and thinking about them. The moon, feeling lonely, feeling happy, life in the future, having a fever. I've got a bit of a cold at the moment. There's so many good ideas there. The shapes you see in the clouds. I went outside, had a look. I just got really wet and it was really gray today. Recipes, prayers, shopping lists. Yeah, talking about your parents. Hopefully none of you have children yet. A historical figure, a very old person. So that could be me. An athlete who's just lost the big game. That could be a fantastic poem there, where you could really talk about that emotion and what they're going through. But I chose language. So I had a look at this webpage. I just quickly Googled weird English words, and it came up. There was 15 on there: kerfuffle, hullabaloo, cacophony, ragamuffin, whippersnapper, gobbledygook, gibberish, poppycock, discombobulate, flummox, curmudgeon, lackadaisical, woebegone, lollygag, and frankenfood. I reckon I knew 12 of those words. Frankenfood I really liked. It's talking about genetically modified foods, and so much of what we eat now is produced in factories rather than grown in the ground. So I really liked frankenfood. Woebegone was one that was new for me, and curmudgeon. Curmudgeon could be me on a morning without coffee. Are you trying to find just the right word for someone who's very bad-tempered and grumpy? Curmudgeon might be just the word that you're looking for. All right, so it's a bit old, but I don't like our teacher. He is a real curmudgeon. Yeah, hopefully you disagree with that. Hopefully, but yeah, could be a good description. So what I did is I copied those words into my stickies app here, and I thought for my poem, because I don't need different stanzas, I could just create some lines and fill them in as I go, and then once I've created enough, put them together and see what the poem says. So far I've filled in 4. Kerfuffle, such kerfuffle is not acceptable. I was so flummoxed as it fell from fork. I had originally from the fork, but that gave me 11 syllables, so I had to take a syllable out there. Dear madam, woe be gone to all your fears. The frankenfood fell off the plate, oh dear. So they're the four I've come up with. And so what I'd do is I'd go through these other 11 words and just come up with a sentence for them that created 10 syllables. I'd use syllable counter because why wouldn't you use such good technology to do that? So I'll quickly do another sentence here before I finish the video. And I might talk about gibberish. All right. So could I say such gibberish? That gibberish. That gibberish is utter nonsense, young man. Let's see what that comes up as. 11. Oh, that gibberish is utter nonsense, young man. What if I get rid of young man and put in here such utter nonsense? That should be 10. Does it fit my iambic pentameter? That gibberish is such utter nonsense. I think that works. So I'm going to copy that from here, put it into my notes for gibberish. And what I'll do is I'd keep putting different ones together, and then my idea here is just to pop them together at the end and to create a poem about, you know, the English language and some of the weird and wonderful words that exist. Yours could be about a feeling, it could be about an event. All right, try and write about something you're passionate about. We're starting our unit for science on reversible changes, looking at the environment. I know many of you are really, really, really sensitive, really passionate about that. So it would be a really good opportunity there to try. So blank verse, 10 syllables per line in iambic pentameter. So 5 feet with emphasis, the stress on the second syllable. No rhyming, okay, at the end of your line. You can use some rhyme if you want in the middle, I guess, but it's not designed for that. You could use similes, metaphors, you could use alliteration, okay? I love alliteration. It could be on anything you want. Let's go for 10 lines, okay? 10 lines of 10 syllables. That's 100 syllables you need to come up with. You guys can do that. There's been some amazing poetry so far in our unit. I'm looking forward to reading these, all right? Thank you very much, guys. Good luck. Have fun with your writing, and be as creative as you can. Thank you.